السلام عليكم. Welcome to a new video on Arabic Language School channel. I am Muhammad Saleh from Egypt. In this video, we will study the subject personal pronouns in Arabic. We will learn their types, pronunciation, correct usage, and examples within sentences. At the end of the episode, I will give you a summary of the lesson. And I will write the summary in the description for you to keep. This video is part of a complete series I am working on to teach Arabic language from scratch to mastery. So stay tuned. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you like the channel and want to support us to continue producing free content, you can visit our Patreon page or join the channel on YouTube. And now, let's get started. A pronoun in Arabic is a word that replaces a noun in the sentence. The single word is ضمير, pronoun, and the plural form is ضمائر, pronouns. In Arabic, the pronoun is considered a type of nouns. Arabic words are of three types: noun, verb, or preposition. The personal pronoun is a type of nouns in Arabic because it replaces a noun in the sentence. We have 12 subject pronouns in Arabic. We have first and second and third person pronouns, and it changes according to gender, male or female, and number. Single, dual, plural. The sum of all this is 12 pronouns. The conjugations of words in the sentence also changes according to the personal pronoun. Whatever change happened to the noun or pronoun, the rest of the sentence follow. Remember this information now because it has applications you will learn when you reach next lessons in Arabic. Subject personal pronouns in Arabic are called الضمائر المنفصلة, which may be translated to detached pronouns because they are independent words and don't attach to other words. This differentiates them from the attached pronouns, which attach at the end of the word. We will study them in upcoming episodes. So we have two types of Arabic pronouns: detached pronouns, الضمائر المنفصلة, and attached pronouns, الضمائر المتصلة. First person pronouns. The first subject pronoun in Arabic is أنا, أنا, I. It is used for the single first person or speaker when someone wants to talk about himself or herself. أنا is used for both male and female without distinction. For male, I say أنا محمد. أنا محمد. I am محمد. Notice that there is no verb to be in Arabic. I say أنا followed directly by محمد. أنا محمد. For a female, a girl can say أنا فاطمة. أنا فاطمة. I am فاطمة. Again, there is no verb to be. Example with a masculine adjective. أنا مصري. أنا مصري. I am Egyptian. Example with female adjective. When a girl says أنا مصرية. أنا مصرية. I am Egyptian. Notice the addition of the تاء مربوطة, the closed تاء, at the end of the adjective to indicate it is female. But the pronoun أنا remains unchanged. The first person pronoun for plural is نحن. نحن. It is written in this way. It is used for the speaker in the dual or plural forms. Examples. نحن نحب العربية. نحن نحب العربية. We love Arabic. This sentence can be said by a group of boys or girls. Again, there is no verb to be in Arabic. The pronoun is followed directly by the rest of the sentence. نحن is also used by single speaker who wants to magnify himself, speaking in the plural form as if they were a group of people. Examples: Allah Azza wa Jal speaks in the Quran in the plural form in several places. For instance, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. Indeed, it is we who sent down the Quran, and indeed, we will be its guardian. This indicates glory and magnification. Also, a king might speak in the plural form for magnification, saying, أمرنا نحن الملك بكذا وكذا. We, the king, ordered such and such. So, these are the pronouns for the first person or speaker. أنا for single male and female. نحن for plural male and females. And sometimes used by single speaker to magnify himself. The second person pronouns are called المخاطب in Arabic, meaning the person you are speaking to. This group consists of five pronouns according to gender, male or female, and number, single, dual or plural. The first pronoun in this group for the single male is أنت. أنت. You for male. Example: أنت ذكي. أنت ذكي. You are smart. أنت عربي. أنت عربي. You are Arabic. أين أنت؟ أين أنت؟ Where are you? أين means where. And again, there is no verb to be. The second person pronoun for the single female is أنتي. أنتي. You for female. The difference between male and female is the final vowel sound at the end of the word. In male, it is ended with فتحة. أنت. In female, it is ended in كسرة. أنتي. أنت for male. أنتي for female. Example: أنتي ذكية. أنتي ذكية. You are smart. أنتي جميلة. أنتي جميلة. You are beautiful. Notice the تاء مربوطة, the closed تاء at the end of the adjective, which means it is a female. The personal pronoun for second person dual is أنتما. أنتما. You both. Used to address two people, whether male or female. أنتما طويلان. أنتما طويلان. This is for two males. أنتما طويلان. طويلان is masculine. We will learn about adjective in later lessons. If you are speaking to two girls, you will say أنتما طويلتان. أنتما طويلتان. طويلتان is adjective for female. So, أنتما is the same. The rest of the sentence is changed according to male or female. The second person pronoun for a group of males is أنتم. أنتم. You all for males. أنتم طلاب. أنتم طلاب. You are students. أنتم أذكياء. أنتم أذكياء. You are smart. أنتم is also used to indicate a mixed group of male and female. In this case, we use أنتم. Then we have the second person pronoun for addressing a group of females. It is أنتن. أنتن you all for females. أنتن مصريات. أنتن مصريات. أنتن جميلات. أنتن جميلات. So these are the subject personal pronoun for the second person or المخاطب in Arabic. أنت for single male. أنت for single female. أنتما for dual male or female. أنتم for plural male or mix of males and females. أنتن for plural females. Third person pronouns. The third person pronouns are called الغائب. الغائب, the absent. They are also five pronouns according to single, dual and plural, and according to gender, male and female, just like the second person pronouns. The third person pronouns for single male is هو. هو. He is. هو رجل ذكي. هو رجل ذكي. He is a smart man. For the single female, هي. هي. She is. هي فتاة ذكية. هي فتاة ذكية. She is a smart girl. The third person pronoun for dual, both male and female, is هما. هما. They are two. Example for male, هما مصريان. هما مصريان. They two are Egyptians, both males. Example for female, هما مصريتان. هما مصريتان. They two are Egyptians, both females. The pronoun for the plural males is هم. هم. They are. Example, هم مصريون. هم مصريون. They are Egyptians. هم أذكياء. هم أذكياء. They are smart. هم is also used for the mixed group of males and females. Like in the class, we say هم يجلسون معا. هم يجلسون معا. For a group of both males and females. The third person pronoun for plural females is هن. هن. They are. هن مصريات. هن مصريات. They are Egyptians. هن جميلات. هن جميلات. So the third person pronouns are five pronouns. هو for single male. هي for single female. هما for dual males or females. هم for plural males and a mix of males and females. هن for plural females. Now we reach the summary of this lesson. I will leave it in the description below. You can copy and keep it. In this lesson, we learned about subject personal pronouns in Arabic. They are two for the first person or المتكلم, five for the second person, المخاطب, and five for the third person, الغائب. Pronouns vary according to gender. Male and female, also by number, single, dual, and plural. We said that personal pronouns in Arabic are considered nouns because they replace the noun in the sentence and follow the rules of nouns. The rest of the sentence is changed according to noun or pronoun. The first person pronoun or speaker are أنا for single male or female, نحن for plural male or females, or for a single speaker magnifying himself. second person pronouns or المخاطب the one you speaking to, أنت for single male, أنت for single female, أنتما for dual, males or females, أنتم for plural, you all males, and mix of males and females, أنتن for plural females. Third person pronouns or absent are هو for single male, هي for single female, هما for dual male or females, هم for plural males or mix of male and females, هن plural males. أنا, نحن, أنت, أنت, أنتما, أنتم, أنتن, هو, هي, هما, هم, هن. Very easy. I hope you review this lesson several times to memorize the pronouns because they are very important for understanding the upcoming lessons. Thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. If you liked our channel and could support us to continue providing free content, you can visit our Patreon page or join channel on YouTube. Thank you. See you next time. السلام عليكم.